Superstitious thinking is something we all fall into, and the National Lottery is a great example of how prone we all are to thinking that our actions can affect random events. We tend to choose numbers that are meaningful to us or according to some kind of system, as if that could magically affect the random drawing of a lottery ball.
In fact, despite there being just as much chance of the numbers 1 to 6 coming up as any other combination, we still continue to choose birthdays and house numbers and the like. I got together with a group of lottery players to see if my own techniques could second-guess their choices.
You need to take a ball out of the bowl, grab a ball, get a mixed ball, one each, please. Thank you, anyone you like. I kind of leave you with that one. Thank you. All right. Inasmuch as these balls are supposed to represent lottery balls, I'm just going to ask you to switch your ball with somebody else's just so this starts off random. Now, you are going to write a lottery number. Make it a good one. Please make sure when you write this number that you don't let anybody see what the number is. I don't want to see it. Don't let the camera see either. So keep it private. A number between 1 and 49. So do that for me now. Make it a good one. When you are done, please throw your pens on the floor. Keep your numbers hidden, please. Thank you. Next, you need to get yourselves into numerical order. So this will be starting with the lowest number here, going to the highest number over there. Take as long as you need to do this, basically, but don't let any of us see the number. Go. Off you go. Lowest number here, going to highest number there. Take all the time that you need. Do not let anybody see the numbers, apart from each other. All right. Could you just hold on to those for me for a second? Don't let me see any of these numbers. This is about the irrational way that we approach playing the lottery, and in particular the numbers that we choose, because the lottery is obviously random, yet we tend to go for numbers that are significant to us in some way, or choose the numbers according to some sort of system or rationale, as if that could magically affect the drawing of a random number. It's actually quite a good demonstration of how we as human beings need to feel some sense of control over random events, and explains why people don't like to use the randomizers when they choose the numbers, because it doesn't give you that meaningless illusion of control. So the question for me is what significant numbers you guys would have gone for. Please be thinking of your numbers. Keep them very clear in your mind. Be saying them to yourself over and over again. Picture them in front. Yeah, I think I know what yours is. Picture them, keep them very clear in front of your minds. Good, can you just pass me an envelope, please? So, you two, both of you, I think, would go for sort of domestic, family, sort of house where you live, that sort of thing. I'm right, aren't I? Sort of maybe house numbers, flat numbers, where you live, that sort of thing. Yes? Yes? Yes. Okay. Please don't look, don't see what I've written. Just sort of hold it against yourself or face down. Can I just grab another envelope? Just hold that down, face down. Please don't look. With you, can I have an envelope, please? With you, this will be something to do with, this will be you, your life, things that you've achieved or not achieved. It's maybe something to do with work, promotions, that sort of thing. How long have you been at work? No? Not really, age you left school? Yes? Okay, think of the number. Yeah, got it. Don't look at it, just hold it face down. Lovely. Yeah, I think I knew what yours is. I don't know what it means, but I think it's that. Hold it face down for me. Grab another envelope for. Sorry, I know it's a bit fiddly there. A house number again, but it probably will be not the house number you're in now. Is that right? Maybe like an old house number, something like that. Yes, yes. Don't look. And you, it's your mum, isn't it? Something to do with your mum? Is that a no? Right, it is, isn't it? You big softy. It is. Yeah. So I've written down the numbers that I think you would have gone for. So starting with you, Donna. You want to show the number that you wrote was number 5. And have a look at what I wrote. Number 5, excellent, good. It was a house number, wasn't it? Or somewhat, yeah. Do you want to just show the ball? What did you pick? 11, and show what I wrote. 11. Lee, age you left school. I said 17. Have a look what I wrote. Do you guys want to just turn yours around, show the camera, do they match? 25, 27, 29. Good, excellent. What was the number? What was the significance?
It's my girlfriend's lucky number in reverse.
As in, your girlfriend's lucky number is 52?
Correct.
That's quite a good one, that's quite obscure. Excellent. Now, of course, the order that you've ended up standing in, of course, also is dictated by what numbers that you chose. If you'd have gone for, instead of a house number, if you'd have gone for maybe a birth date or something like that, I'm imagining you could have ended up elsewhere in the line. So with that in mind, Donna, isn't it? You've all got name badges on. Donna, just turn over the card that you're stood on. And just, can you actually stand up with it, let the camera see it? Donna, Claudio, do you want to do the same? Claudio, Lee, do the same for me. I think I got all these right. Thank you. And again, you three guys, just do it. Just turn them over. I think Paul, yes, Yvonne, and Stephen. Well done, well done. Thank you. So the cards that you stood on predicted the order of numbers that you would choose, the numerical sequence of your numbers. Drop your cards, drop the cards. Of course, it isn't just the way we choose the numbers that's irrational. There's also an irrationality often to do with the way that we might reflect on winning the lottery. If you imagine that you've dreamt some numbers and then you decide to play those numbers and then you win, it seems amazing, you know, 14 million to one, whatever, it seems amazing, too much to pass off as a coincidence, enough to make people believe in premonitions. The reality is, though, of course, you forget that there are millions of other people who may also have dreamt numbers and played them that then don't win and, of course, get forgotten about it. So the reality is, there is no coincidence at all. It's somebody somewhere has to win and they're bound to have a story. We need a winner for our imaginary lottery game here, and it needs to be chosen at random. There is quite an effective random generator going on here, which is the ball that you have in your hand, and that you took a random ball out of the bowl and then mixed them randomly as well. One of those balls has inside it a lucky symbol. It's actually a little, it's a four-leaf clover, not a real one, I hasten to add, a paper cutout. Oh, it's you, Paul. Excellent. Yes. Well done. Just show the camera. Can we let the camera see this? Excellent. Well, congratulations. You are our lucky winner. Would you open your envelope, please? This is the envelope that I wrote my numbers on that I thought you'd say. It says lose. Would you do the same for me there? Open it up. Lose again. Open it up. Lose. Hang on to yours for a minute, Paul. Open yours up, Yvonne. Lose. And last one, Stephen. Lose. But, Paul, if you open yours, it says win or nim, depending on which way up you hold it. Congratulations. You are our lucky winner. And if you just come over here, Paul, as you leave, if you pick up Paul's ball there on the floor, which you've put down there. If you just come and stand over here for me. Just hold the balls together, just so we can see the sequence of lottery numbers. Maybe up a little bit. Okay, so we have 5, 11, 17, 25, 27, and 29. You haven't seen your prize yet?
Absolutely not.
It's in the envelope. There's something else in there. It is a lottery ticket. This is for this Saturday's draw. That is your prize. Do you want to just read out the numbers that I chose on the lottery ticket?
5, 11, 17, 25, 27, 29.
The numbers that you chose predicted on the lottery ticket, that is yours. It's in the draw for Saturday. I hope you win. If you do, I expect a phone call of you. We can arrange some sort of commission. Thank you very much.
Speechless. I don't know how he does it, especially the fact that we've picked all different balls as well. Because I actually had yours and we swapped at the last minute, didn't we?
I don't know how he did it because he didn't spend any time with us, so I don't know how he could read it just from our faces. I've no idea.